So I'll start to say a little bit about myself. I'm a user experience consultant at Web Credible, which is an agency in London, close to London Bridge. I'm the co-founder of Playhouse, which is a group of people like us interested in user center for children. I'm the UXPA UK secretary, and we have an event on the 19th of March in London. So tonight I'd like to talk about the project I did for my dissertation. So I graduated in 2012 from City University London with a Master in Human-Computer Interaction Design. So for my project I work with children age 4 to 6 to design a mobile application to learn the name and the sound of the letters and to read simple words. So just to make sure, ABC is the name of the sound, Abacu is the sound, okay? So being an academic project, I had to do lots of research on the best practice of working with children as design partners. So as you can see, there are many methodologies from UCD to cooperative inquiry. So cooperative inquiry is the methodology with the highest user involvement. So what it means that the user, the children, are considered at the same level as adults. So they're not considered lower, but at the same level as everyone else. So what is cooperative inquiry? Cooperative inquiry is a methodology created by Professor Henderson Druin from the University of Maryland. And is the result of years of working with children aged 7 to 11 years old who go to their lab once a week after school, and during the summer they go for 2 full days. And they work together on the design of technology, which I think it's great. I like Professor Alison Bruin, and I like the work she's done and she's been doing. So in cooperative inquiry, the child has got 4 different roles. So he's seen as a user, as a tester, informant, and design partner. And it's got these 4 different roles according to the interaction or how it works with the adults. For example, is a user when it tests technology designed is a user when he uses the technology designed by the adults, okay? And the adults just observe the child. Is a tester when they test the technology designed by the adults before the technology is released to the market. Is informant when the child inform the adults in some ideas and some sketching, but is not on the same level. Design partner is when the child is on the same level of the adults, so they work together, they collaborate together on the generation of new ideas. So for my project, I wanted to work with the children as design partner. So there are different cooperative inquiry is a methodology. What it means, there are many methods, many techniques used in this methodology. So there is observation, when the adults and the child, they work together and they observe other people using technology. Interviewing, when adults and children interview others using technology. Critique, when together they critique other systems. Brainstorming of ideas. Mixing ideas, which is quite interesting, when you've got many different ideas and together you try to put them together to come up with only one idea. Layer elaboration, which I quite like, they use acetate sheets to generate new ideas. So you design something on this sheet and then you put another one on top and you add new functionalities to the design. Low-tech prototyping with our supplies for the idea generation. And when we want to set expectations, so we wear informal clothes like, you know, the children, everyone. The adults at the same level of the children, no hand raising, use the first names and not Mr. or Miss or Madam. There are no right answers and all ideas are good ideas. And then reflecting as a group presenting and adult debriefing. this is, you know, this is a methodology, this is academia, right? So it's all been, you know, written in a paper. And then I wanted to do some research on the best practice on creativity. So we know there are many creativity techniques used when we work with adults, okay? But what we use, which kind of technique we use when we work with children. So with my research, I found out that at the time, 2012, the best creativity they used was brainstorming. Brainstorming together, and then storyboarding, and then comic boarding, which is a technique that they use these specific books created to make the brainstorming a little bit more interesting for the children. But I was not interested in that. I wanted to use something new. So I wanted to use the creativity technique of dressing up. Okay, and I'm going to tell you a little bit more later. So for my session, I organized two sessions, a game session and a design session. They were done in a primary school in London in July, 3 weeks before the end of term, and 1 week apart on Thursday afternoon. So the children in a reception class, so with children aged 4 to 5. So the children went to school, they said the lesson finished at 3:25. I went there, I had two children aged four and two children aged five. I fed them, so I gave them something to eat and something to drink, okay? The mothers were there with the teaching assistant. Again, is an academic, is from university, so I need to have ethical approval from the university, and there were some rules I had to follow. If you go there as an agency or client, probably you don't have to follow all these rules, but it was an academic project. So we start after, you know, they finish with their food and laugh or whatever. In the game session, they play 5 different games where I observe their movement. An example was I gave them an A3 paper with parking spots design on the paper and letters in each parking spot. And there was the teaching assistant saying, can you please park your car on the letter B? And then they had the little car and they had to park the car on the spot. And it was interesting to me because there were some children parking forward, some children parking backwards. So through this design, through these games, and the observation, I found the requirements for the application. So what it means that when you're using the iPad and you move an object, you should be able to move it backward, forward, you know. It might be clear and, you know, we should know these things, but again, because it was an academic project, I had to find out and I had to have the proof. More interesting to me was the second session, the design session. As I said, I wanted to work with them as design partner on the same level and come up with ideas for the design of this new mobile application. So I asked them to dress up. So I had 4 children, as I said. I had a Ben 10, I had a Peppa Pig, I had a pumpkin, and I had a Spanish flamenco ballerina, okay? So when I started the session, both sessions, first of all, I introduced myself, of course, and then you know, I told them about the session, what we were going to do. So in the design session, I said we were going to design an application. I asked them what if they knew the name, what design meant, and they said no. So I took the example of the builders. When they build the house, first of all, they design, they draw the house, the body of the house, and then they build it. It's the same thing, okay? And then I asked them if they knew what an application was. Yes, it's a game, okay? I asked them if they knew what an iPad was, and they knew what an iPad was. And then I told them, okay, now we're going to be inventors of technology. I wanted to them to feel important, so I want them to feel inventors, you know, good, okay, let's do it. And then, so As I said, I had four different costumes, and after I told them, explained what we were going to do, I started the session asking some ice-breaking questions. For example, what do you think Ben 10 had for breakfast this morning? What do you think he did today? He went to school. What did he do at school? He learned the letters. Remember, they were at reception. So when they were in the reception class, they learn, what they do is they learn to read. So they learn the alphabet, they learn the name and the sound of the letter. So of course it was, you know, they did that. They did what I wanted them to, you know, to generate idea. So, okay, so they went to school. So what did they do at the school? They learned the letters. How did they learn the letters? So I had four ideas. Ben 10 didn't learn the letters because he was so clever that the letters went straight into his head, okay? Peppa Pig learned the letters with a clown. Fine. The pumpkin didn't learn the letters. He learned how to blow fire, how to fix up. Fine. And the Spanish ballerina learned the letters with a teacher and a whiteboard, which is probably what she did during the day. So to me, these four ideas were original, okay? I mean, it's nothing to do with letters. It's nothing, probably the Spanish ballerina is about experience. But the other three ideas are original to me, are, you know, and this was important to me because they didn't copy anything from anyone. While one of the techniques, as I said, in a cooperative inquiry was to observe, it's called technology immersion, I think, is observe other people using technology. I didn't want to use this technique because I was aware that these children could have copied ideas from the other technology. I was more interested to have original ideas. And then I had these four ideas and I asked them to draw their ideas on the piece of paper they had in front of them. And so this is an example of the pumpkin, okay? What I wanted to do after was to use the mixing idea technique. I had four ideas and I wanted to go down to one idea. So I tried in different ways. I told them, you know, think about ice cream when we mix ice cream together. Think about the coloring when we've got different colors and we mix them together to have a different, you know, a new color. It just didn't work. So we couldn't put the four ideas together because at this age, children are very jealous of their own ideas. They can't let go. So in this case, the project failed. I couldn't mix all the four ideas. I had four ideas. Again, these children were quite young. What it means they can't concentrate for a long time doing the same task. So I had to keep changing task. I had to kept them busy, otherwise they would have get bored. So after I failed with my mixing idea, I presented them with some Playmobil toys and some Lego, some stickers, and try again to mix these four ideas and come up with one idea for the design. It didn't work. Next, I gave them a carton board iPad. Okay, so they felt, oh, I've got my own iPad. I've got one here, and this morning I showed it to my son, who is 8 years old, and they said, oh, I've got my own iPad now. But of course, right. So I cut the white paper of the same size of the screen, just to make it more real, and I asked them to design again, their own idea. So the Ben 10 and the clown and these kind of things. It didn't work. So because they were too young and they got bored quite easily, it was July, it was hot, it was the end of the school, the end of the week. I couldn't push them too much. I had to let go. So the main goals of my project were, first of all, to design an application, and secondly, to create a low fidelity prototype, because when I show you this one, it was mainly to create a low fidelity prototype. So I failed in creating the low fidelity prototype, but actually I had four original ideas, and to me were, you know, were great, because you know, I never seen learning the letters using, I don't know, Ben 10, you know, going the letters into your head or something like this. So what I did, because again it was my dissertation project, I created wireframes and I implemented these four ideas into my wireframes. The application was never been built, because there are thousands of these applications on the market, and to be honest with you, I didn't have the money to pay a developer or everyone else. So, you know, it was my project, and I think, yes, it failed in the low fidelity prototype. I was successful on having my four original ideas, so I was quite happy about that. So anyway, so the techniques I used was to give them importance. I told them the purpose of the session, and I explained what design was, what the application was, what we were going to do, and then I told them we were going to be inventors of technology, which, you know, they liked it and, you know, they felt important. To generate some design ideas, I used the dressing up. So I don't know if you're aware, but there is a creativity technique for adults called superheroes, where the same, you use mask of your superheroes and you think about the powers of your superhero and how your superhero would solve the problem using their power. So it's a kind of similar, right? So yeah, dressing up and the mixing idea, which didn't work. Anyway, to build the low fidelity prototype, I used the colored pens and the paper, the Lego, the Playmobil, the stickers, and cardboard, iPad. What I learned, so have clear goals in mind. You know, you should know what you want to find out. Be organized, as you know, we were saying before, because things can go wrong. And open-minded, so take what you get. Again, you know, I failed in having the low fidelity prototype, but I had my four ideas. Try to work with children at the same age. Why? Because we were saying before, 1 year of difference is quite, you know, it's quite important at this age. So then someone is, you know, more shy than other. It was quite difficult. The Peppa Pig was quite shy. It was quite difficult to, you know, to get out their idea, so try to work on this with the same age if you can. Make the children feel important, because they are your users, they are your stakeholders, they are yours, you know, the people you're working with. Thank and reward the children, so I gave them some books and stickers, and, you know, I gave them the extra prize, which is chocolate when they like it. And surprised, but I had to check with the mothers first, yeah. Or, yeah, the books and stickers are usually quite, they like. And then thank and reward the school and the parents, because, you know, you were saying you had a drop-off of children, because, you know, children are busy, you know, they've got their own activities after school, and the parents as well, so you depend from them. And you should say thank you, because, you know, they help you out. So, some names for you, if you don't know them already. I quite like Professor Alison Druin. She's done lots and lots of work, cooperative inquiry, but other kind of work. So I quite like her. She works for the University of Maryland. Deborah. So she's, last year, she published the book Design for Kids, and she's been doing lots of work with kids as well. Again, both of them are based in the US. In the UK, I quite like Professor Jennifer Lee, I think. And do you pronounce it Kichi? I'm not sure how you pronounce it. Chiki. Okay, Chiki. From the University of Central Lancashire. And again, they do lots of work with children and schools. And so in academia, I think Professor Alison Druin and Professor Janet Reed, they're yeah, quite like their work. So that's me, that's my experience. Thank you.